et bienvenue sur le plateau d'Inclusive Day. Aujourd'hui, nous accueillons Henriette Rosenquist. Vous travaillez depuis 18 ans au sein du laboratoire biopharmaceutique mondial Pfizer et vous avez pris les rênes de la filiale française en 2018. Alors, vous y menez une politique très inclusive, très ambitieuse, avec des résultats probants, puisque vous avez obtenu, par exemple, une note de 98 sur 100 à l'index d'égalité professionnelle. Pour vous, l'entreprise doit jouer un rôle au sein de la société. Alors, ma première question, c'est qu'est-ce qu'une entreprise inclusive, selon vous? Qu'est-ce que ça doit être, une entreprise inclusive?
I think, and thanks a lot for asking the question, by the way. I think for all leaders that it is to take the opportunity, but also an obligation to be a vocal voice in terms of diversity, inclusion, and equity. And I think in for Pfizer, we have it very strongly embedded in our culture. So also when we talk about equity, it's not about that all colleagues will be the same, but actually the colleagues who need more, we do more for them to be at the same level. So that's about equity. And what is important for us is also that when we make the environment in the organization, it's important for us to have a spirit of diversity. So in terms of each colleagues, no matter what background they have, no matter what experience or any perceptions they may have, they all need to be seen, they need to be heard, and they need to be cared for. So that's part of our inclusive environment for Pfizer. And we make sure that in spite of all this diversity, we create the spirit of respect from each other and also the openness from each other in the organization. And that's what we believe will create much more innovation, creativity, higher performance, and even better results. And the diversity for our colleagues is exactly the same as diversity for our patients, because we're working in a pharma organization, so we're actually looking for the patients or working towards the patients. So that's why diversity and inclusion for us is so important.
Alors prenons peut-être le premier sujet, celui du handicap. Donc parmi vos nombreux engagements, qu'est-ce que vous avez pu mettre en place? Comment ça s'est concrétisé dans votre entreprise?
Yeah. I think handicap is very close to my heart. I think it's very important, again, when we talk about being part of a pharma company, we are committed to health. And that's also raised the awareness of handicap. So in Pfizer France, we have put a very strong message and measurements in place to make sure that we include also diversity in terms of handicaps for our employees. Mm-hmm. So due to this strong policy in place, I think we have more than 6%, 6.4% mm-hmm. of employees who have handicaps in the organization. So every time when we recruit for new colleagues, we make it very clear for our talent and acquisition, but also for recruiters, that handicaps are part of our DNA and that's part of our inclusiveness in the organization. Mm-hmm. Further, we have liaised with Marianne Monchamp, who was the former Secretary of State and actually initiated the disability law in 2005. So we use her as an advisor and collaborator to invite her into our organization, discuss with her how can we actually improve this going forward. And also that she meets some of the team members so she can feel and see that we are genuine when we are talking about handicaps. And one more thing, just giving an example. So November last year, we invited job seekers who have disabilities, not physically, because we have the COVID crisis, so we invite them in for a virtual meeting. But we explained a little bit and showed how we are working in the office so they could realize what kind of jobs could be important for them. And then we had kind of a tutor function. So some of our colleagues help the job seekers to help them to apply for positions and make sure what is important when they apply for a job. So I think that's very important for us to have that part of our organization as well.
Alors maintenant sur le sujet de la parité, vous nous expliquiez que vous mettez en place une situation de... Enfin, vous voulez promouvoir une situation de win-win pour les hommes et pour les femmes. C'est pas toujours simple à comprendre pour tout le monde. J'aimerais bien savoir comment cette politique est mise en place concrètement. Comment vous arrivez peut-être à emmener tout le monde sur ce sujet-là?
I think I'm a strong believer that it's essential that examples come from above. And when I took on the role as president for Pfizer France 2 years ago, it was very important for me to present myself as an executive leader, but also as a mother. I think it's very important that colleagues can see that you can have a successful career and not jeopardize your family life or sacrifice your family life in a way. So really make sure that we have the work-life balance going on if you want to have management in your career as well. So that was very important for me to show that case. And I think what is important here is make sure that we show youngsters who grow in our organization. So we put in place for development our talent, to make sure that they have this kind of flexibility, work-life balance, how they combine their professional life with their private life as well. So this is one of the things we're doing in the organization as well. We also make sure that we increase the flexibility in the organization. And we can actually see by the terms of the COVID situation right now, we have experienced that everybody is working from home or télétravail. We can see that you can actually combine and make it much more flexible in your working hours. So we have to think about when we are coming back, that after the COVID or post-COVID, that should we put some more flexibility in our working environment into the organization. We believe that will be a competitive advantage for us going forward. So this is what we have to look more into. Maybe coming back to the example of our organization. So in my board of directors, we are 50-50 male and female. When we looked into the management, we are 70% females in the organization. But when we look into management, it's only 56%. So there is a work to do there even more often. And I think also what's important for me, coming from Denmark, I'm Danish. You have in the Danish labor law on the agenda parity, And it's an issue carried out by both the man and the woman. So it's not because the woman or the women have to conquest the men, but they should see it as a win-win situation here, that if you also do and leverage the females or the women in the organization, it also is a benefit for the men. So we have this diversity. And again, coming back to, we believe that diversity foster more engagement in the organization, better performance, different way of reaching things.
En parlant de diversité, il y a un autre axe majeur de votre engagement, qui est celui de l'inclusion des communautés LGBT+. Oui. Est-ce que vous pouvez nous expliquer comment ça se traduit également en interne et est-ce qu'il y a encore du travail à faire? Est-ce qu'il y a d'autres projets par rapport à ce que vous aviez déjà mené?
So sexual orientation is a private matter, that's for sure. But I think, again, we need to have a vocal voice to create an inclusive environment in our organization, in our working environment. And that's why also we need to avoid that we have homophobic behavior or discrimination in our organization. So for us, it's important to create this environment. And I'm very proud of, in 2017, we were the first pharma company who actually signed the charter for L'Autre Cercle, which is an association where really make inclusiveness of LGBT employees in the organization. And at the same time, we created a working group in Pfizer, which create the awareness of the LGBT colleagues. We even celebrate the months of Pride or the Pride months in June. And I think also to combine all this together, we also ask the colleagues, do you believe of the diversity we are putting in place with all these measures? And actually 93% of our colleagues or employees believe that this is what we are doing. They do see we are facilitating an inclusive environment here. Mm-hmm. So again, working for the minorities are of course something we need to look in as leaders in the organization.
Merci Henriette Rosenquist d'avoir témoigné des mesures qu'a mis en place la société Pfizer France. Vous pouvez retrouver évidemment tous les autres témoignages d'entreprises et les autres lives sur Inclusive Day. À très bientôt et bonne continuation.
Merci.